Yeah, this is the second part of the literature survey module on how to use tools such as Web of Science and Scopus to collect bibliographic data onto your desktop. The objective being that these data can then help you write an article or your thesis and populate the bibliographic fields in your thesis without having to type out every different bibliographic data field that you need. And this second part of the module, I am going to use Scopus as a source of bibliographic data. As usual, again, we must make a disclaimer. This is a checklist that we must have before we start a literature survey using the Scopus as a tool. We must obviously ask whether we have access to the Scopus tool. So, please do ask your librarian if you have subscription for Scopus. And if yes, then is this access via an IP address or a roaming login? And if the access is through IP address, whether do you need to access it through a proxy? And if it is through proxy, then whether it needs a username and password, and whether you have such a username and password with you to be able to start the literature survey using this particular portal. If it is through a roaming login, then you must get the username and password for you to log in through the portal. So, assuming that you have that information, then we can go on to now start the literature survey on this portal, and I have given the URL of this portal here. And in case the URL of this portal happens to change because the vendor or the company has changed it, then please do search the internet for the words like Elsevier and Scopus and identify the correct URL. In case you do not have access and you want to open this portal, then this is the screen that you will see. Namely, the screen will not let you search for anything and it will ask you to log in, because it detects that you are logging in or trying to access from outside your institution's network. If you have already registered for access through your institute at least once, then it may detect that you have logged in and provide you a partial access. However, you need to actually log in before you start any process. And this is how the front page would look like in case you have access, which means that you are ready now to search, because the search form is readily available for you. And I advise that you can register and log in before you start searching, because you can actually keep the history of your literature survey and all the search results in organized fashion in your own profile, and that will be helpful for you to start off your work from where you left last time you did the literature survey. So, some checklist before you can start the process: register yourself, obtain a login and password on Scopus, and again for the profile you must use official email so that you will be able to show your affiliation to an institute while you do your literature survey, and have these credentials handy so that you can log into the portal whenever you are required to do the literature survey. And once you are logged in, you can save your searches and search history. And this is how it looks like. When you click on the link register, there is a small form that will be shown to you. You can fill all these fields. Naturally, you are expected to agree to the license terms and then register. Once you register, then you can log in by using this login form, and you can ask the portal to remember your login so that you can perform the literature survey in different sessions without having to log in a second time. So, we are going to show a demonstration using a keyword based search, and we are going to use the same set of keywords as we have seen in the other module on Web of Science. We must choose the fields very carefully. The set of fields that are available in Scopus are slightly different from those that are available in Web of Science. You can actually choose article, title, abstract, keywords, all of them together, and search for a set of keywords in that, or you can choose them in authors, first author, source title, article title, abstract, keywords, affiliation name, etc. You should also pay attention to the time span, and you can choose a time span either from a particular year to another year, or you can choose all years till the present so that the search will be done across the entire database. For a person who is doing the literature survey on a topic for the first time, it is advised that the entire time span is used for literature survey. The subject areas also have to be chosen up for appropriate links to show up. An engineering topic need not be searched, for example, in the medicine area and vice versa. However, it is again advisable to keep all the subject areas open so that you may find interdisciplinary results that will be showing up. You can actually also perform advanced search features using a search string that can combine different fields values, Boolean operators and parentheses if you are already familiar with advanced programming or SQL syntax. And this is the form that is used to search for the literature. This is at the front page. I have already logged in, as you can see from my name here, and the search history then will be stored in my profile. You can actually have multiple fields, and you can add additional fields by using the plus button here, and you can combine your searches across multiple fields using either or AND. I would advise or, because you can get a union of all the different results. And in what fields should you search these keywords for is evident here. You can press this drop down menu and you would see a list of fields that will be appearing. And what are the various fields? You can actually see that the fields are available in such a way that you can choose from the dates, the citations, the relevance, the first author, and both the forward and backward sorted order, as well as from the title. And here I have put a star against the cited, because it is very important for a novice researcher to identify what are the publications that are referred by a large number of researchers in this area, so that you identify the important pieces of work in this area immediately. And I have searched as an example for two phrases, rapid solidification and melt spinning, and combined them with a Boolean operator OR, so that I am getting a union of these two. And I have obtained number of hits 22,000, which means that this is a fairly mature area of research. And on the right hand side, you can see that these results can be sorted by date, citations and relevance. And in these three dots, if you click, you get four more ways of sorting, namely the inverse of the date search, basically where the oldest paper will be coming on the top, and the first author searching, both backwards and forwards sorting order, as well as the source title. And how do we then collect the reference items that we need from this list? What we need to do is, for each method of sorting the results, we should select those we feel are important for our literature survey by checking the box against those items. And then we can click on the button Save to List to add these to our list. And then we can click on the item Enter the list name of a new list, if you want to create a new name for this list, or we can also add them to an existing list that we have created just now. And the number of items added to the list will be shown, and we must verify that against what we are searching. And once we are done with collecting, then we can click on the link View or Manage your saved lists, so that we can go to a three-step process in collecting the data. I am illustrating them here. You can use these click buttons to identify those articles that you want to collect, and then click on the Save to List button here, and it will open up a dialog. It is asking you whether you want to save these items as a new list or an existing list. You can choose as appropriate and click on the Save List, and those items will be in your list. And those lists are then shown to you here, and you can see that I have just given a name called RSP Melt Spinning 2 for this literature, and I have only identified 8 publications right now to save. And if you click on this link, then you can see those items that we have just now identified, and they are listed here. And what is the process now to export them? This is quite straightforward. We have taken efforts to sort in a different manner and identify most important publications. Therefore, all these we can actually pick up for our literature survey. So, you can click on this button here, where you can select all the items that you have identified. This will not pick all the items for the search that you have originally made, but for only those which you have picked and added to your list. So, first we select all of them. The second is to click on the export button, and that will open up a dialog here. The dialog is fairly elaborate. Okay, in the dialog, we must choose the format of the data that we want to take. The format can be chosen to be RIS format, CSV format for Excel, BibTeX, or text format. I would advise you to choose the BibTeX format, because that is a native format for many reference management software, and also it can be converted later to other formats. And what information do you want to take along to this BibTeX format is again available here. You can click on this drop down menu, and you can choose, as I would advise, citations and abstract information, because very often it is important to read the abstract, so that we can identify those among these publications that require you to go to the full text. Once you have chosen the options here, then you can click on the button Export here to export this data as a BibTeX file onto your desktop, and it will come to your desktop as a file that can be saved in your downloads folder. Okay, here is a summary that we have done. Click on the name of the list to view all the items that you have selected and saved. Click on the checkbox at the top of the first column of all the items to select all the items. Click on the link export to open up the pop-up dialog. Choose BibTeX format, citations and abstracts, and click on the button export to save the results as a file named scopus.bib. Go to your downloads folder to rename the file to something meaningful. For example, you can give the same name as the list that you have written, and you can store it in a safe place that you can look up later on. And how does this file look? It is very much similar to the other demonstration we did on Web of Science. In a notepad, it would look like this. Every item would have an at symbol and an article type followed by the data, which is human readable. The full text is available in ASCII format. You can read it here. You can also use the notepad to cut and paste different bibliographic items from different bib files that you may want to combine or split. In TechMaker, it would look like this, neatly organized by different fields. And in TechWorks, it would look like this, again neatly organized. These two tools, TechWorks and TechMaker, are freely available for all platforms for you to install. And my favorite would be then JabRef, which is a software that will let you show the literature data as a spreadsheet. And here we can see, and we can identify any of these items, double click to edit and add notes, and we can read the abstract within the software itself, and you can also export the data in multiple formats. And how do we edit these bib files so that we can mix and match, combine, etc.? We always need a reference manager, and I would suggest JabRef because it is open source and free, and it has a spreadsheet like appearance. And JabRef gives you the possibility to add notes, split and merge different files, export to different formats. What is more important is that these files reside on your desktop, which means that you can go through these items at your own pace, offline, and identify those among these papers where you want to read the full text. And why do we need to export these bibliographic data? Again, the logic is similar to what we have shown on Web of Science demonstration. Scopus is giving you the data as a bib file directly, and you can use this bib file LaTeX software to create your article. And you can also use JabRef software to convert the bib file to an XML file, which can be then used in Microsoft Office to create your article. In other words, you can perform a literature survey in a citation database such as Scopus, export the data and use it directly using typesetting software such as LaTeX or Microsoft Office to generate your article references at the end of the article, and you can also use it for your thesis. Thank you.